If you haven't already seen our previous videos on Fort Wayne's hidden gems, I'm going to show you another. This is the wooden nickel. I'm going to show you guys around. Let's take a look and see if we can find some of my favorite bands. I am big on 90s alternative and also some 2000s alt too. Got some Matchbox 20. Matchbox 20. Rob Thomas. Ooh, John Mellencamp. So I actually went to college at Indiana University in Bloomington, Indiana. Small town with not much besides the college, but beautiful Southern Indiana. John Mellencamp grew up there. He wrote a lot of his songs about Bloomington. He lives there now. His girlfriend, Meg Ryan, shops at the local health food store there. I ran into her a couple times while I was there. Oh, but ain't that America? You and me. Ain't that America? Something to see, baby. Who doesn't like Stevie Nicks? Come on. Iconic. Oasis, One Hit Wonders mostly, but Wonderwall. Everybody likes Wonderwall. Ooh. Okay, No Doubt is one of my favorite bands of all time. Maybe my favorite, maybe, but I like a lot. So this was their Tragic Kingdoms album. This was Gwen Stefani before she was Gwen Stefani. She went real pop there, not as big of a fan, but No Doubt was a ska band in the 90s. Her band was excellent. Her music was excellent. They did album covers like this with a shopping cart full of oranges. Come on. Paramore is obviously not 90s alt, but Hayley Williams is one of my favorite singers. Hey, I've even got the Hayley Williams hair. This is like 2000s punk pop alternative. This is a throwback to my high school days. Big fan. Pearl Jam, again, top three favorite bands. I could pick any album out of here and tell you that I liked it. I love them all. Eddie Vedder is amazing. People give him shit because you can't really tell what he's saying in some of his songs, but that's not the point. The music's good. He actually wrote a lot of songs about his stepdad, who he was not fond of, and that's most of his iconic music. My favorite, most people haven't heard it, it's called Elderly Woman Behind the Counter in a Small Town. Like, nobody knows that Pearl Jam song. Far and away the best one. Most of you probably have not heard of the Pixies. I hadn't either until I watched the movie Fight Club, which most people have seen. They have a song in there called Where Is My Mind? Where is my mind? Where is my mind? I saw that movie, I heard the song, and I had to go find out who it was. So then I started listening to the Pixies. Another one to check out. Queen, come on, everybody loves Freddie Mercury, but that's a gimme. Favorite Queen song. I'm a karaoke host, so I'm gonna have to go with... Noye, what's your favorite Queen song?
It's cliche, Don't Stop Believing.
Wait, what?
That is a Journey song, my friend!
Oh, I'm sorry. You're not a... Yeah, sorry, my bad. Sorry.
It's another big one at karaoke, but Stone in Love is my favorite Journey song. Britney Spears was my elementary school icon. Actually, when I was 6, I sent her my school picture that I signed it, and she sent me back an autographed photo of her, and that was like the best day of my life. Oops, I did it again. Kicked ass for me. Spice Girls, tell me what you want, what you really, really want. You want a house in Fort Wayne. Third Eye Blind's another great 90s alt band. So Semi-Charmed Life is the song everybody knows. Semi-Charmed Kind of Life, baby, baby. Semi-Charmed Kind of Life, baby, baby. Anyway, that whole song's about crystal meth, so I just ruined it for you, sorry. Rick Astley. You gonna throw a Rick roll in here? Have you ever heard of Young the Giant? No? Okay, Young the Giant is kind of an indie band. I like indie, I like folk almost as much as 90 alt. Cough Syrup is my favorite. I also like Your Side, 12 Fingers, but go listen to Cough Syrup. That's a good one.
Why do you like Cough Syrup?
It's provocative. Yeah. It gets the people going. Ooh, Bare Naked Ladies. Okay, so funny story about Bare Naked Ladies. I was like 7 and I heard them playing at the Navy Pier venue, which was 21 and over, so I couldn't get in. But we were walking on Navy Pier and I heard them and I really liked their music. 10 Things I Hate About You is my favorite movie ever. It's super 90s and it's actually really good. Julia Stiles and Heath Ledger as like a kid who was amazing. Anyway, The lead singer for Bare Naked Ladies loves to play pinball, and so do I. And he visits Fort Wayne anytime he has a concert nearby and comes to Wizards World, where I play. So they've met him in there several times. I haven't been lucky enough to catch him yet. But if you want to potentially meet the lead singer of Bare Naked Ladies, come check me out at pinball on Monday nights.